On today's episode, will this technology save the internal combustion engine? Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. In the internal combustion engine world, there have only ever been two successful operating principles, four-stroke and two-stroke. Now, we all understand the operating principles behind piston engine technology, and many of us are familiar with variants like the Miller or Atkinson cycles. But in essence, internal combustion engine technology has not changed in over a century. Granada, Spain-based INNengine, however, has developed a novel new engine technology that the company boldly states will revolutionize the internal combustion engine, a one-stroke, valveless, and crankless opposed piston design. Mechanically, the engine uses four cylinders arranged radially around a central shaft that carries cam tracks on which the pistons ramp up and down in the manner of a roller lifter in a conventional internal combustion engine valve train. Compression is created by the combustion chamber formed by the two opposing pistons, much like successful diesel applications like the Junkers Yumo and the Napier Deltic. And like those diesels, the INNengine uses cylinder wall ports for breathing, closing the exhaust ports before the intake ports to create uniflow scavenging. Gasoline direct injection is used and the charge is spark ignited. The system is effectively a two-stroke design with an innovative mechanical coupling to the output shaft. The clever cam track system not only eliminates the crankshaft, but by phasing the cam tracks relative to the output shaft in the manner of current variable valve timing technology, the system can create variable compression ratios, which opens interesting possibilities for engine load management, control of spark knock, and emission controls. The company has built working engines, including prototypes for aviation use, and is talking about alternate fuels, including hydrogen. From an engineering perspective, there are questions about this engine's viability for production automotive use. Without the mechanical advantage of a connecting rod and crankshaft, low RPM torque would appear to be limited, suggesting higher RPM operation with short gear ratios. Lubrication of the entire system, especially the cam tracks, is an unknown quantity, as is the ability of the system to meet very strict modern emission controls with gasoline fuels. Scavenging the cylinders will require careful tuning, possibly by ram effect, and more probably for production engines by blower scavenging, as seen in the venerable GM 71 series diesels. But the concept is intriguing, especially as a small auxiliary engine as a range extender for electric vehicles. Could the INNengine keep the internal combustion process alive in the age of electric vehicles? Here at engineering.com, we'll be following this interesting technology and we'll report on developments going forward. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.